All right, so we've already talked through how to do probability problems with the simplified version of the normal distribution table, but now we're going to look at just a small part of a real Z table, right? So with that distribution I drew before, right, it had a z-score of 1 on there, and it went down to z-score of 2, but now the z-scores are broken down to the hundredths place, so it's a much finer granularity. So there's one column that you'll need to identify for whatever problem you're solving, which is the z-score, and then you can use these. These tell you what the percentage is that's associated with that z-score. And let me just draw one of these, and we can work through it. Okay, so earlier we talked about how with the simplified version we said we said that there was 34% of the overall area under this curve that was in between 0 and 1, right? But now with the more accurate z table, what we can do is we can find for a z-score of 1, z-score of 1, 1.00, we find that 34.13 is the percent in between the mean and that z. So the percent in between the mean and a z of 1, so that's the exact same area we had before, that percent is actually 34.13. And when we did the simplified version, and we would have done beyond 1, right? We said that this was about 14 and this was about 2. So together, those in the simplified approach, those would have been 16%. But now with the more precise Z table, what we can do is we find our Z score and then go from that Z out into the tail. So here's our z-score of 1, and now we're going to look at this column here called percent in tail. So that's the percent for that z-score beyond that number. So we have 1, so 15.87% of this distribution is beyond the 1. So the actual percent is 15.87%. So the Z table lets us do much more precise calculations of the areas under the normal distribution. So the Z table can be used whenever you have a normal distribution. So if you're starting off with the distribution of Whitman's heights, because that's normally distributed, if you just transform that whole distribution into a standard normal distribution, then you can apply the Z table to calculate whatever kind of percentages you need. And I want to point out that this is just an excerpt from the table. This just goes from a Z score of 0.97 to 1. So that's a really small part of the table. Most Z tables go from 0, right way up there, down to a Z score of about 3.5 or even 4. And if you recall, the Z of -3 to +3, that's 99.7% of the whole area under the curve. So after 3, there's not much change in these values. But this is just a very small excerpt that we're going to be using for our examples that we work through right now. And another feature of this table is that almost always you only have positive z values here. You don't have negative z values. And the reason is because the distribution is symmetrical. So the area in between the mean and 1 on the positive side, that 34.13%, is the same is the area between 0 and negative 1. It's symmetrical. So when you're working through these problems, you got to keep it straight for yourself how to translate positive and negative z-scores from the table to whatever problem you're actually working.